Thank you, sir. Indeed, a very good presentation, I must say. Small tip to students, just don't start chanting the mantras, but follow the tips and start executing those tips to achieve your goals. Is that what I want to say? With this note, we move on to the next speaker, Dr. Bharat Mansukhlal Modi. Having completed post-graduation from Mumbai in 1981, Dr. Bharat has 33 years of total teaching experience, academic council member at various universities and former principal of Jodhpur Dental College and K.M. Shah Dental College, has conducted various workshops, recently conducted webinars on faculty development too, has keen interest in evidence-based dentistry, teaching technology, forensic odontology, 3D printing in medicine and dentistry, developing accreditation standards, has several national and international publications to his credit. Waiting to hear from you, sir. We welcome you, Dr. Bharat Mansukhlal Modi. Over to you, sir.
Welcome, everybody. Thank you for the lovely introduction. And I would like to thank the organizers for having me here to have a talk with you people. This presentation comes to you from JSS, Indian Academy of Oral Medicine, and Association of Oral and Maxillofacial Radiology and Oral Physician of India, AMROPIN. It's a small task force with IOM. I am also a 3D printer printing expert. So this is the logo of the AMROPIN, and I have created the 3D print of that particular print. The handsome face you see is my own. I am Dr. Bharat Modi, and I am going to give you this presentation. So welcome to dentistry. You have taken the step of entering into the dental field, and you are ready to blast off your career. But blasting off is a very small part. The landing is more important. And for that, a career planning is most important for you people. This career planning should be started from now itself. If you have the focus, tomorrow I want to be this, then in that particular case, the skills which are required, those should be started acquiring from now itself. So now that you have chosen dentistry, if you remember in 1972, when I first became entered the BDS arena, so I am not only old, I'm ancient, prehistoric, and antique piece. And today, if you see, 50% wants to go for dentistry. But for me, if you ask me today, I would prefer dentistry anytime. I agree that dentistry is having a very stormy weather. There are a lot of dark clouds around, seats not getting filled, saturation in practice outside. But every storm, and this storm is present in every field, but this storm has got certain areas where light shines through. And you have to plan your career in such a manner that you go to those light sources so that you can have a very bright future. And that means that you have to have a change. There is a time for change now. Dentistry was in a downward slope for some time, but we were having inertia. We didn't change. But with this pandemic, I think now that impetus for change is definitely there. And that is why, and we know for sure that better things are to come. But for that, you need to metaphorize yourself, not to a dragonfly or to a butterfly. What do you metamorphose yourself is a different matter. But what is important is both the curriculum as well as our personal attitude has to change so that we can achieve our goals. During the past, what happens is everybody used to go into dentistry and just pass out without any change. Everybody used to be almost similar. Now in the future, you will have to be different. If you want to stand out in the crowd, then you have to be different. And every person who is listening to this talk should know that there are different ways in which you can be different. And that itself will make you the success mantra, which the previous speaker was talking about. Now, in the by the end of dentistry, you will have many options left. You could do MDS and go into academics, which is very good. But there is one problem with being in academics. and that is what I'm talking through experience, that paycheck which comes at the end of the year one is always a very addictive in nature. It is worse than tobacco because it makes you stagnate, that it doesn't allow you to spread out. So apart from that, if you go for entrepreneurship, consultancy and clinic, that would really make the icing on the cake, you know. So if you do MDS, you do academics as well as start your clinic, then that would be the best option for you, for your personal growth, the growth of dentistry itself also. And that is why you should choose very wisely. So let us see now that you have decided that we should take up dentistry and we should take up private practice. It should start from your preclinical days. Acquire all those skills which will be required for having a very good practice. It should be so much that in your preclinicals, you practice so much that it becomes a habit. And once it becomes a habit, even if somebody wakes you up at 2 o'clock in the morning and tells you to do a class two, you should be able to do it. And don't look at quota system. We have a quota system which is given by the Dental Council of India, as well as all the colleges are following it. Problem is that you are more than interested in getting signatures. What is more important is to see what work you have done. Now, when I was a student, I was told by one of my staff that I don't want to go for a quota system. You just give me 5 good class 1, 5 good class 2 cavities, and that is good enough for me. We were very happy that the quota is gone. But for doing those 5 good cavities, we actually did 20-25 cavities because we were looking for quality and not for quantity. And that is what you need to learn. Always go for quality. Try to see what you are doing and self-evaluate yourself. In the clinic also the same thing, the scenario between of your typodont and that in the natural condition is much different. The patient's tongue, the saliva, the swallowing method of the patient, everything is going to create a lot of problems. So not only your skill is important, but also how you manage all this is important. In internship, you need to go for observers and assistant course, because your prior practice is your aim. You have to learn how other people do, and then because it is not taught to you in your college. So you have to learn and observe and create your own system. But the most important thing is that you need to go for a good communication skill. You need to be very approachable to the patient. Patients want to talk, and in communication it is not what you talk but what you listen that is more important. You have to be a very good listener, and patients would like to tell you different things, and you have to be smiling and very professional. Your attire, your demeanor, everything has to be so good that patients start liking you. And that is what is going to be your success mantra. Communication skill is most important. And mind you, there will be patients who will come because they have gone through internet and they have some misconceptions, and they will come and argue with you. Some people will come and bargain with you. And all those times also, you will have to keep on smiling. You cannot have problems that time. If you get angry, then you will lose those patients. That is why it is very important that you keep a very smiling face. You can add 20% in your quotation which you give it to the patient. That will be good enough for you. The next part which you do is have safe practice. Your practice should be very safe. For example, in the first photograph, the person is leaning and it is unbalanced. Second one, person is bending so much. You are going to practice for the next 40-50 years. So ergonomics is going to be very important. In the third picture, see how the spine is straight and head is only mildly tilted. Have safe practice in the form of infection control. When we started dentistry, we had standing practice. We never used to wear gloves. Now things have changed. Infection control is and with this pandemic, PPE systems have come in, and this is bound to continue in the future also, because we are in the era where chemical and biological warfare is going to take place, and that is why you have to be prepared. You have to practice safe radiology, because every time you are taking a radiograph into in your clinic, you are exposing yourself also for the radiation. People go for IOPs in the clinics, thinking that I can charge 200 rupees and my costing is only 25 rupees. I am earning 175 rupees per X-ray. So if you are taking 12 X-rays, 2000 rupees I am earning just from X-ray. But look at the amount of radiation which you are absorbing. So what you should do is go for an OPG straight away, rather than going for a IOPA. OPG, yes, you will not earn anything from out of that. But what is important is that OPG gives you the full mouth picture and not only the three teeth where the patient has a chief complaint. So when showing the patient that he has got so many problems in the entire mouth, you are converting a simple case of chief complaint into a full mouth rehabilitation. Practice management, financial planning, stress control, should be, you should ask your management to do it in your internship, and have a good friend circle, because they are the great stress busters. Women in dentistry has come up a lot. In fact, in Ahmedabad, there is a clinic run specially by women, and it is for women itself. Now, that is why when you choose a practice, don't use this for getting a good husband or getting a good wife or getting a rich husband or a rich wife. None of this is permanent, but you standing in your on your own feet in private practice is what is going to take you along throughout your life. The second option is doing MDS. There are 9 specialties which you have. Now, oral medicine and radiology are split into 2 parts, the general practice part and the oral radiologist. I have done general practice because oral medicine is the entire dentistry itself, from caries to syndromes and genetic diseases to cancer. Everything is covered in oral medicine. All the branches are included in oral medicine. Oral radiology, on the other hand, is becoming a specialized branch because of the lot of innovation which has come. So recognizing the importance of MDL, one of the this webinar's chief thing is shown here. So make a smart decision which branch to choose. Now you have so many branches, 8 branches are there. I'm leaving out oral medicine. The 8 branches which are there, the fundamental basis of that is good diagnosis and good radiology. That is what is going to sustain each and every branch. And oral medicine already has this. So you identify and develop the branch which you would like to go, taking into consideration that your final aim is going for clinical practice. Now, if you are doing that, try to evaluate what are the things which are shown here. In all the branches, what you are doing is manual skills development. Now, there are short cases, manual skills can be developed. And application to private practice is important. For example, orthodontia, people want to go for aligners and lingual orthodontics, which is not much taught. Oral surgery, people want to do jaw surgeries, but you get only to observe. Oral pathology, you want to do immunohistochemistry, you want to go for proteomics, you want to go for genetics, that may not be available. Public health and dentistry also the same problem is there. In prosthetics, root and endodontics, implant problem is the only major thing which is there. But today, even BDS people with their short courses are doing implant. So as I said, KK, you need to have a change in the curriculum. All these branches will need to have change in the curriculum, including oral medicine branch. Now, oral medicine has got a lot of potential. It takes into consideration the oral cavity, the head and neck portion as well as the human body. The radiological part have started now 3D. The CBCT, which has come into the 3D scanning, which has come into picture, that is really improving on the different parts of diagnosis and interpretation. So if you see here, you can change the views in your 3D CT, and you can see how the teeth appear in different sections. Now each sections will give you different information. So your total interpretation, because of this radiological new technique of cone beam computerized tomography, has really improved the role of this thing. Even in normal 2D X-rays, which all other branches are using, your specializing in oral medicine and radiology gives you an extra edge. For example, this X-ray, you have a large cavity and there is a periapical on the distal root. Mesial root, the lamina dura can be traced up. Now, naturally, you have to go for a root canal in this. But when you go for doing root canal, because pulp is white, partially vital, patient is going to have a lot of pain. So when you tell the patient beforehand, yes, you will get pain when I'm opening the root canal, the patient will not feel that you are a bad dentist. Rather, he will say, yes, you had already warned me. And when you give intraligamental injections or you give intrapulpal injections, in that way, pain can be controlled and they will be very happy with you. Similarly, many times it has been claimed that when you're doing a root canal, lateral canals have been obliterated. But many a time, these are all fractures. If you see that there are fracture lines seen here at this particular point and at this particular point, which can be seen here also. So your diagnosis becomes very important. And that is why your dentistry will also become important. And that is why choosing oral medicine, because it is a physician's and he's a radiologist also. He's full of knowledge because the entire dentistry is known to him. He is very skill-based, and completeness and thoroughness is part and parcel of being an oral medicine specialist. So when you want to go for comprehensive treatment, it is prudent to take up oral medicine and radiology very seriously. The oral medicine and radiology specialist is a master of all, and not only in the diagnosis, but treatment planning, which is there, that part, because he knows the entire dentistry, that is why treatment planning also is better, because he looks at the teeth, he looks at the oral cavity, he looks at the body, and he looks at the general systems of the body also. And that is why comprehensiveness comes naturally to him. And most important is that the 3-degree digitalized approach, which is there, which oral medicine radiology people do, makes him very good for diagnostic and prognostic purpose, and the quality of life also. The quality of life can also be maintained by the oral and maxillofacial radiologist, and is ideally suited for giving treatment provider. So if you want a holistic treatment, if you want comprehensive treatment, then comparing and contrasting with the other branches, oral medicine is a holistic branch and it should be preferred if you want to go for practice. I'm just limiting myself to practice. Mucosal lesions like ulcers comes to in a dental clinic quite often. And you will be good to know that there are more than 20 causes for oral ulcers. Now, normally when the patient go to some dentist, he will just prescribe antibiotic and anti-inflammatory, which will not help the patient. And the patient will jump from one doctor to another. If you comes to the oral medicine, he will give you assured diagnosis, targeted treatment, healthy outcomes, no over-medication. And that is why this kind of patients will always remain with you. They will be your loyal patients and they will bring in more patients also. if you want to see systemic like diabetes, endocrine disease, hormonal disease, all this has got some effect in the oral cavity. In fact, WHO has given a maxim, oral health for general health, you know, or the mouth is the mirror of the body. That was given by WHO. Even in my practice, I have seen in the oral cavity, ask the patient whether he has got diabetes. And if he says no, a random blood sugar was advised, and the patient gets surprised. How did you come to know that I had got diabetes just by looking in the mouth? That is the quality what oral medicine can give you. He is expertly trained in that, and that is why your practice buildup is better with this. Oral cancer, you know, early diagnosis is important. So early diagnosis and confirmed diagnosis can be done very easily. Now, whether that medicine is ulcerative, nodular, proliferative, whichever type of ulcer it is the oral medicine specialist who can easily diagnose this, and the treatment can be started very early. At the same time, after the treatment, the quality of life these patients have are very, because of the extensive surgery and all done, they have a problem of the health status, financial status, emotional status, and social and psychological status. Patients whose salivary glands have been removed because of the surgery will find difficulty because there is no saliva in the mouth. And that is where, when supplementation and everything is given, and the rehabilitation of this patient, the oral medicine person is trained to do that. Joint problem has become the major issue, and we and oral medicine people have taken it up quite a lot. With the coming of T-scan, defibrillation, jaw thrust, all TMJ problems can be solved. And you'll be surprised that migraine, earache, headache, neck ache, back pain, and shoulder pain, all of them has got some relation with the TM joint. Correcting that TM joint can relieve you of all these kind of different problems also. And that is why many oral medicine radiology specialists have started their own clinics, diagnostic clinic, where they do pain management, they do this joint corrections, they do CBCT, as well as do biopsies and things like that. So this is the branch which is expanding quite a lot because of the technological inputs which are there. Patients are always will come with certain amount of disabilities, whether it is physical, whether it is medical, psychological, emotional, and how to change your treatment planning depending on what condition he is, what medicines he is going to give, is getting, and what medicine you are going to give, what type of anesthesia to give, which time the treatment should be done. All this planning which is there can be done by the oral medicine person because he's keen to do that. And that is why when you have to choose this specialty, just remember OMR specialist is the person who will really care in the real sense of the word, because he has got all that particular knowledge at his fingertips. Which brings up to the next portion, that is my innovations. As I told you, I do 3D printing, but throughout my career, I have done lots of things. Zero radiography, transcutaneous electric nerve simulation through the Ayurvedic chakras, autoradiography, densitometer, radio spectrometry, artificial caries, all these things which I have done, and today I'm doing 3D painting. Am I a genius? No, I'm an average person. I'm not a genius. Then what makes me do all this innovation? For that, a very simple example. Last Diwali, we were making sweets in the house. I started helping out, but I got bored. And immediately I did different types of shapes, a triangular shape, like a samosa, a cookie type, a biscuit type, different types I prepared in that. Why did I do this? It is because you need to think differently. If you want to innovate, if you want to metamorphosize, as the previous speaker spoke, then you have to do something different. That difference can come only if you start thinking differently. Even the workshops which I take on evidence-based teacher training, 3D printing, forensics, all this are not something which other people do. If you remember the slide where the egg was, all the eggs were there with one metal egg there. That difference which is there is in your thinking, not in your ability. Abilities will come, but it is your thinking which is most important. So what is 3D printing? 3D printing is just that when you do a 3D scan, you can convert that, part of it can be converted into a model. In anatomy, in the first year, you used to use patients' mandible. Now these were all dead patients. Whereas 3D printing, you are getting the same thing, but on a live patient. The patient is sitting in your chair when you are getting his own inner parts outside, so you can observe and treat that person better. So if you have a lesion, how the lesion has destroyed the mandible, if you want only the enamel or the root canal of a tooth, or if you want a whole tooth where you can do root canal, which is not possible in your trichoderm teeth, or if you can give colors so that enamel is of a different color, dentin of the different color. If you have a lesion which is there, that lesion could be printed in different colors. And this can be act as a museum piece also. You can build up your own museum. You have the case history with you. You have the 3D printed model, and you don't need to keep this model in formalin or in glass jars. They can be kept lying down. If you have a lesion like this, what is the lesion like? You are only having the radiographic interpretation. But what do you see that in? To see that, you can go ahead and do a 3D printing. In 3D printing, from the skin to the muscles to the different organs like your salivary glands or the bone, everything can be printed, and printed separately also if you want to, or can be printed together. That is the beauty of doing 3D printing, that everything can be represented. You can have casts for your forensics or for all of them, because they will be preserved. They will not break very easily. So much so that if you in the third trimester, when you do 3D sonography, I can print the child face so that you can see how the child is going to look once he's born. This of course is not allowed in India, because then you will come to know the sex also. But the capability, I'm talking about the capability. Any part of the human body can be done. If ear replacement has been done, an ear can be produced. If you want to study the spine, the heart, the lungs, and you see the accuracy. I have put the hand also along with it. Everything has been reproduced in a most perfect way. The hip, pelvic, and the surrounding muscles of the pelvic all can be seen very easily. And if, as the previous speaker also said, that if you combine the 3D scan with 3D printing and with augmented reality and virtual reality, the whole healthcare delivery system, oral healthcare delivery system, can be changed to. And Jio is probably coming out with this kind of glasses by the end of this year or probably beginning of next year. And so within 2 or 3 years, this technology is already upon us. So OMR Expert is a complete package, from diagnosis to treatment planning to treatment execution and radiological evaluation at every step. Gives you an edge towards your private practice which you want to. So if you want to have a complete package where you have an expert diagnostician, you have a comprehensive dentistry giving, superior radiologist, and a 3D printing expert for pre-treatment, during treatment, after treatment, and preparing guides for them, oral medicine radiology person can really make a difference. That doesn't mean that other branches do not do. They are also doing fantastic, but a little change in their applicability to dentistry in private practice is needed. So choose wisely, And there are certain skills which you should know. Communication skills, there's a foundation of practice, detailing, which an oral medicine will be able to do, manual dexterity, both in clinical and preclinical, leadership skills, organization skills, patience, physical stamina, problem solving and care. All these things are not taught in your, but these are the skills which will help you in your private practice. And that is why oral medicine is important. So I wish you all to be the best clinicians ever and choose wisely, plan properly, plan now itself for the future which you want. Thank you very much for patiently listening to me. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bharat Modi, for giving us good tips for clinical practice and emphasizing on diagnosis. Also on letting us know how an oral medicine and radiologist can put up a clinical practice other than academics. And your innovative thinking and positive mindset was very inspiring to all of us. On behalf of organizing committee, please accept our sincere appreciation in the form of e-certificate.
Thank you very much for sharing your vast experience with us today, sir. Thank you once again. Have a good day.